Hey, what is up, guys? I'm your local newscaster, Wand Wanderson, here today. And today, I'm bringing you all the latest and greatest tech and gaming news. I fucked this up hard. I'm not stopping. Fuck this. Anyways, today, I'm going to be talking about my opinion. Oh no. I'm the next Keemstar, aren't I? I'm a news channel talking about my own opinion. Fuck off. Anyways. This is not news. Alright, USB Type-C is not news. It might have been a while ago. It definitely was a while ago. Let me rephrase. It was definitely news a while ago. The tech community was blowing up about it. And now it seems to be slowly being integrated into almost everything. Monitors, laptops, motherboards, like the obvious things like laptops. If it's a good peripheral, good interface, laptop manufacturers and motherboard makers, they're going to more than likely integrate it into their product. I've seen like PCIe extension cards that have it. Surprisingly, most of them only have like one, maybe two ports. That's just funny to me because I have like a 4-port card that's USB 3.1. I'm not sure though. I'm pretty damn sure it's 3.1 though. Anyways, so this is USB Type-C is very, very cool to me because it's slightly bigger than micro USB, but it is a lot more durable. That's not a big reason. That's why I'm kind of bringing it up first. Just get it out of the way. It's a lot more durable than USB or micro USB, which for Android users, they're constantly having to replace these cables. Sometimes like 3 times a year or something with USB Type-C, you may get 3 years out of it. I'm pretty damn sure. Granted, your phone's battery lasts that long. Planned obsolescence. Am I fucking right? The fuck pisses me off. I'll maybe make a 4th video today talking about that shit. But that's beyond the point of this video. So we're not going to talk about that today. What we are talking about today is the, is USB Type-C. We've seen full 4K monitors running at 60 FPS, I believe, 60 FPS, with extra bandwidth to plug in, like, a mouse and keyboard into the monitor and through a single USB Type-C port on your PC, you're able to do all of these things that I'm about to list. Power the monitor, alright, so no extra power cables needed. Display 4K 60 FPS and still have enough bandwidth left over to plug in a mouse, keyboard, and maybe a flash drive. Granted, that flash drive will probably have to be USB 2.0 spec. And not only that, but like a mechanical keyboard and gaming mouse, which are normally more power consuming. Okay, bro. That's pretty cool. Thunderbolt 3, which is based off of USB-C, actually is able to provide up to, I believe, 100 watts of power. Holy shit. That's a lot of power. Now, we have seen smartphone makers integrate Type-C into their phones. The most notable of which is OnePlus, integrating it into OnePlus 2 and OnePlus 3, possibly OnePlus X. I'm not sure about that. I often forget about OnePlus X because it's just not really OnePlus style. But OnePlus 2 didn't really utilize USB-C as well as it could have, while OnePlus 3, on the other hand, comes with like a 4-amp charger, get like boost charge, what is it, 60% in like 30 minutes, So this phone charges from 0 to 100 in less than an hour. And that is just amazing to me, considering back when I had an iPhone 3GS, back when that was relevant. It took multiple hours for that to charge. My Nintendo DS, that takes multiple hours to charge, and both of those batteries combined, I'm pretty damn sure, don't even equal one battery that's in the OnePlus 3, which I believe is 3,000 milliamp hours. I believe the 3DS has like a 1,200 milliamp hour, and then the iPhone 3 had like a 1,300 milliamp hour. Something like that. So yeah, add those together, you get like 200 or 2,500 milliamp hours. Yeah, that's not much. You're getting an extra 500 milliamps getting OnePlus 3 and probably saving yourself a lot of money and getting probably a lot worse. Oh. Okay, what am I talking about? Okay, I lost my mind. Why is this open? Oh yeah, the previous video. Okay. So personally, I believe that soon monitors, most monitors, not all monitors, will not need, like, they will not have a power cord with, like, a power brick included. Well, they will. They'll include a Type-C. They'll still use HDMI, DVI, VGA, DisplayPort, whatnot. All that shit. Why did I list VGA? Because, like, my old rig was a Sandy Bridge. My only options were VGA or DVI. And I didn't have a graphic card in that system, so shut the fuck up. Now I'm not sure how this works. I'm not sure if by using a Type C port on the motherboard, if you have a graphic card in there like a GTX 1080, if you're able to really utilize the graphic card. I think you are, but you have to do something in BIOS or something. I'm not so sure. I'm pretty damn sure you're able to do things like that. Whatever. I'm just pretty damn sure that you're able to, like, if you have a GTX 1080, obviously that doesn't have a Type C port. Like, if you have a USB Type C monitor, I believe you are able to, I believe you are able to utilize your card while having the monitor plugged into your motherboard, even if that is your only monitor. Because, as I've said previously in the video, I believe that Thunderbolt 3, it may just be normal Type-C, which is capable of full USB 3.1 speeds, by the way, which I believe is like 5 gigabits a second, or just 1 gigabit shy of what SATA 3 does, or SATA 6 gigabits a second, as many people call it, which is approximately 600 megabytes a second. For those of you who don't know, the difference between a byte and a bit is 1/8 of a byte. And it pisses me off that the bit measurement system is a goddamn thing, because then, like, internet service providers can use it and make their contracts sound a lot better than they really are. Like, oh yeah, 100 megabits a second. There's like no difference. My mom got real pissed off. This is for another video. I'm just bringing it up now. My mom got real pissed off at the cable guy because she asked him, what's the difference between a megabit and a megabyte? She didn't know. Okay? When he was setting up our internet, and he's like, oh, there's no difference. Which they should be told that there is a difference. All right? Because she has like a 75 megabit plan over there, and he said there's no difference. Okay. Sir, there is a difference, and I'd like to point it out to you. All right? A bit is 1/8 of a byte. So, like, when my mom saw that, like, she wasn't downloading at 75 megabytes a second, she's downloading at 30 because we apparently have two bands. We have a 2.4 gig, 2.4 gigahertz, and a 5 gigahertz band, which her laptop's so old that it can't link to the 5 gigahertz band. So she's got that going for her. I keep bumping my mic, so just ignore me. So she got real pissed off, called Comcast, and was like, "Yeah, I was told there's no difference between a megabit and a megabyte, but I'm only downloading at like 3 megabytes a second." And the guy on the phone was more helpful than the guy who came to our fucking house, and told her there is indeed a difference. And basically said what I said. They just use the megabit system to make their plans look better than they really are. Anyways, that story's for another video. I don't know what, because that's basically the whole fucking story. God damn it. I'll go more in detail in another video, possibly, if you guys want it bad enough. Just don't send me pictures of your massive erections if you even have a massive erection. If you're watching my videos, do you have a big dick? No, you don't. That's the answer to that question. Anyways, another one of life's mysteries solves. I saved the day. Solves. Free! I saved the day again. Anyways, so I personally do believe that USB Type-C is going to take over a lot of interfaces. I believe maybe like 50 years from now we'll have like an upgraded version of Type-C. That will be much more powerful, and most everything will run off of it. It'll be like a universal connector. Hell, maybe even internals of a PC will use that. Like, maybe we'll have little internal SSDs that just hook up through Type-C to your motherboard, and little mechanical drive is just hooks up through Type-C into your motherboard, gets power and data that way. God, I'd love that. So, like, yes, SATA may not have a use anymore, because that'd be much easier. We just have, like, maybe an extra power connector from the power supply to the motherboard, which for modular power supplies, that's not going to be that big a problem. We could just, like, if it's not like a PCIe power connector, for example, like, if it's not like that, which I don't think it would be, but it's possible. It's possible. What we could just do is, like, I'm damn sure if this happens, like, Corsair, EVGA, and people like that, these companies will release cables like that you could just go and buy for like $3. Maybe more than that, maybe like $10. Because power cables are power cables. Because, like, here's a picture of my current setup, because my 2 terabyte drive is dying. So, here's a picture of my current setup. Let me mark this. All right. Anyways, so that picture is of those 6 hard drives are all in my rig. All right. Keep that in mind. All those hard drives, they are in my rig. 4 of them are 500 gigabytes, and they are housing a backup of my 2 terabyte, which is dying, and that top one is an SSD. See how bad of a cluster that is? All right. Now, here's just a picture I found online. All right. So this picture is of a data center where wires are just they're fucking everywhere. And like yeah, Ethernet, I'm not gonna say that it's gonna the USB Type-C is gonna take over Ethernet because that's a very fast interface. Granted, USB is kind of faster, yes, but I don't think it's gonna take over Ethernet. We do have USB Ethernet adapters, and it is very possible that it does take over Ethernet because yeah, it is. USB can be kind of faster. That's weird. Why is this on the Ethernet cable? Son of a bitch. yeah, it is a very fast interface, and like 50 years from now, who knows the speeds we'll be accomplishing? We will probably be beyond the petabyte. That'd be pretty damn cool. Those of you who don't know, a petabyte is the next step up in computer memory from a terabyte. 1024 terabytes is a petabyte. I don't know what comes after. I think it's like an exabyte or something. I don't know. I'm pretty sure there's something in between petabyte and exabyte. Yodabyte? No, I think yodabyte is the largest form of computer memory that we have right now. Eh. Penis byte. Numbers are infinite. You know that's gotta be a thing somewhere. Somewhere along the line, a penis byte is a thing. How do we get to talking about penises in this video? Come on, there's Wand Wanderson. The channel's name is a euphemism for a dick. Fucking hell. Oh, boy. There's a hole in my pants right now. Like, right where my nutsack is. It's a very small hole. Like a needle dick probably couldn't even fit through this, but it's noticeable. Now we're talking about needle dick. Is this a video about interfaces anymore? I don't know. But yeah, I do firmly believe that soon, like, optical drives, if those are even still being manufactured 50 years from now. I doubt that. I heavily doubt that. I mean, maybe for a select few people, I still have an optical drive in my system. But, God knows I very rarely use it. The last time I used it was actually not too long ago. I used it, like, about 5 days ago. Me and my friend watched SpongeBob. We have a few SpongeBob DVDs that we watched on it. It's not a Blu-ray thing. We have a Blu-ray player, but the Blu-ray player doesn't like DVD. It can play DVDs, but it plays them back very weirdly. It was like a Black Friday Blu-ray player, so this isn't very surprising to us. But yeah, we just put them into my computer. Why am I just telling stories? Let's get back on topic. So yeah, USB Type-C is a very, very interesting interface. I've already said this, but yeah, soon I do believe that you're going to buy a brand new keyboard, and it'll be USB Type-C, and then the back of your board is just like 30 USB Type-C ports. Alright, you know, just like this. Just like that, you know. Because that's a thing. Again, found that online. But truly, USB Type-C is very interesting. I want to see everything begin integrating this. I want to see mice integrate this, keyboards, smartphones. We have smartphones integrating this, but I want to see more. I want to see Samsung's next phone use it. I want to see LG's next phone use it. I want to see Blue's next phone use it. I want to see OnePlus is probably going to use it. I want to see all these big smartphone manufacturers start to adapt it. Now, it's already in laptops. We already have laptops. We already have, like, flash drives with USB Type-C. Samsung's new portable SSD, like the 2 terabyte or whatnot portable SSD, that uses Type-C. So the technology is there. The technology is most certainly there for this. And I like it. I want to see something unique. Okay. I want to see a SD card reader that internally has type C. I want to see hard drives, internal hard drives that use type C to connect to the computer. SATA's long gone. All right, this is the future, all right? I'm talking from the future here now. SATA is long gone. SATA hasn't been used in fucking 20 years. So SATA's not being used. And we don't care because USB is much faster than SATA now. It's faster than SAS. If any of you even know what that is. It's faster. Alright? End of story. It's just faster. The end. So, cable management is a dream. Because for power to all these hard drives, we don't have to hook up a SATA power connector, Molex power connector. We just don't. We just don't have to. We hook up a single cable. And then we hook up a extra power connector to our motherboards right next to the CPU power connector. Just right next to there. Or maybe just the 24-pin ATX power connector. Maybe we could use that. Let's just use that. And so we just hook up type C. It's a hard drive. It's a motherboard. One cable. 20 hard drives. 20 cables. No big deal. 10 yottabyte server. 50 million dollars. No big deal. No big deal. CPU fan? Nah. Water cooling. USB Type-C. Oh, monitors? USB Type-C. Power supply? Not USB Type-C. I have a feeling we're going to be using the standard connector for a while now. For quite a while. Especially if Type-C is only capable of 100 watts. Mouse? Plug it into the monitor. Type-C. Keyboard? Again, into the monitor. Type-C. TV? Type-C. Cable box? Type-C. Type-C. I have a feeling that we're gonna have extension cords. Eventually. That'll plug into a wall normally, but they'll just have a ton of Type-C ports. Because Type-C is a very powerful interface. Now, I may be very ambitious here. I know this. But Type-C is a very powerful interface. And I want to see it become widespread. Now, it is fairly widespread right now, but really only to people who care. People who really don't care about it don't have it. And I don't think they know what they're missing out on. Because Type-C... Type-C is a sight to behold. I love Type-C. Alright? It's a lot more durable than micro USB for phones. It charges a lot faster because of its superior power delivery. It transfers data faster. Granted, your phone can keep up. Not all flash chips and phones are equal. May the silicone lottery be on your side. Mine wasn't. Whatever. If you're wondering what I mean by that, my graphic card does deliver 970 performance, but I am unable to overclock it, to any degree, really. Now I've seen people overclock it just by pressing a few buttons to get 20 extra frames out of game or something. I'm just pulling a random number out of my ass right now, but I can't even do that on mine. So I guess I got good enough, but Could have been better. I don't care, really. It still provides 970-like performance, or 970 performance like it should. It's a 970. So I'm fine with it. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about USB Type-C down in the comments below. If your feelings cannot be described through the comments, be sure to make a video. Email it to me at this email address. Yeah. Okay, sorry, I'm marking things. Anyways, be sure to email it to me. I might respond. Now, I'm not gonna make a reaction of your video. I'm not like that. But who knows? I may do something. I may call you out. I may, like, mention your video in one of my videos. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? I am a whale. Anyways, guys, I'm your local newscaster, Wand Wanderson. Be sure to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe. And I'm signing out. Maybe another video a little later today. Bye-bye. Stop.